My name is Eliza Bailstein. I am so honored today to be a part of the Rising Light Weekend Retreats. All month long, we have had the most incredible teachers sharing their hearts and their time and wealth of knowledge with everyone, just in order to lift up the community. And I'm so honored to be part of this. I, along with being one of the organizers of Rising Light with my partner Hal, I am a self-care advocate and educator. I work and play with children of all ages and adults and teach effective strategies for finding some peace within the chaos and for really having happy and healthy bodies, minds, and spirits. That is my passion, and it's something that I want to share with you all today. I know that we are all going through all sorts of crazy times, and more than ever, this kind of information needs to be shared far and wide, and that's why I wanted to do it. Before I get going on a kind of discussion about some of the strategies that we can use to find some peace, I wanted to start with an expressive meditation. This is something that has been used by our ancestors for as long as humans have existed, and actually animals do this too. When you're in the midst of traumatic experiences, when you are in that fight or flight mode, once you get through it, it's important to shake it off. And so this is an exercise that we are going to be moving out that stagnant energy. And I would like it if everybody who is watching this today could go find themselves space where they can be able to move, to be able to rest at the end, and also just feel free of distractions so you can really focus. The biggest thing here is to recognize that this is about healing ourselves. Don't worry about whether this makes you look silly or feels uncomfortable, because it kind of does for a lot of people in the beginning. But the real purpose here is to come into your body and to really feel a sense of calmness within yourself. So we are going to start with a breathing exercise. We're gonna have my assistant, Prince Halbert, come and join us for some of this exercise movement. Here's my prince. So we're going to start first with a breathing exercise. So if you can place your hand on your belly and your other on your heart, and just take a notice of what your breath feels like. Is it short? Is it labored? Are you feeling the breath come more into your chest? There's no right or wrong way, just notice. I can feel my heart beating. This is my first live stream and it's freaking me out a little bit, but I'm excited too. But okay, so we're going to first start with some belly breath. So when you take a breath in, I want you to breathe in through your nose and out through your mouth. And feel your belly expand when you breathe in. Breathe in as though you're smelling the sweetest aroma. Maybe some baked bread or some flowers. And then blow out like you're blowing out candles or dandelions. Keep going, feel that breath. Try to extend it out when you breathe. Slow, soft breath. We're gonna do about three more of these. Really breathe in through your nose. Out through your mouth. one more. Make this really nice long one. Blow out. Okay. Now I'd like you to be standing and have yourself standing on your feet. Your feet are planted. Your knees are going to be loose. And we're going to start with a shaking exercise. And we're going to listen to some music just to give us some length of time to know how long we're going to do this. But the goal here is to be moving from your feet. You're going to be pushing from your feet. Your knees are loose, and you're going up and down, almost like you're Oompa Loompa-ing at first. There we go. So feel yourself let go of your jaw, feel your neck moving, but we're going up and down. Your feet are firmly planted on the ground. You're up and down. Feel your scapula, your shoulder blades going up and down. And you're going to do this as rigorously as you can. So really let your body go. Close your eyes so you're free of distractions. If you're feeling silly, good. Silly is a good thing. Remember, the coolest people don't care if they look cool, because they know inside they're just right. So just keep on going up and down and feel yourself really shaking. We're activating our vagus nerve right now. This is what lets us let go of any of that excess energy. We're ready to move through. Keep on going. Really let your body shake. Keep on going. Keep on going. If you feel tired, just go harder. This is your time. Keep breathing. Keep going. You can let your hips go side to side. Let your head move. Keep on shaking. Imagine what it would be like to be electrocuted. Let your head go. Your feet are planted. It's almost done. Shake, shake, shake. Keep going. Almost through it. Keep breathing. Really go. Shake, shake, shake. Feel your whole body going. Breathe in. Keep going. Okay. Go, go, go. Last little part. Okay. And you can take a break. Take your time. Put your hand on your heart, your hand on your tummy. And breathe in through your nose. Can you feel your heartbeat? Is it going hard? That is your rhythm. That is the beautiful music that moves your soul. You're creating this open space for yourself. Feel that through your body. Now, we're going to do the dancing part of this. And this, I want you to let loose everything that you've been holding on to. Let your hips open, let your shoulders get wide. This isn't a particular type of dance. This is your dance, whatever the music is telling you to do with your body. Who can help us better than Bob? So just moving your shoulders, open yourself wide. This is your time. Let go of anything you've been holding on to. Stay present with your body, with the music. Dance if you want to. Snap. Arms up. Spaghetti arms. This is the time to experiment. Your body is beautiful and created to be able to be moved all around. I like doing some of these. Hip open. Feel that breath. Through your body. Keep on moving. Moving. It's your time. to our Prince Albert for coming to join us today. We're going to come back and talk over here. I'd like you to take a moment, really feel your hand on your heart, on your belly. I hope you feel a soft, sweet smile coming across your face. Strong heart beating through you. Yeah, I hope you feel that loosening of the tension that's coming through. That exercise that we just did activated our vagus nerve. Our vagus nerve goes from the base of our skull all the way down to our thorax, out in branches out, and it's responsible for us resting and digesting. So you've probably heard of the fight or flight response that we have, and that's something that's deeper in our brain that is really great in short amount of time. It helps us get away or fight whatever kind of predator is coming at us. But if we're always in that state, we end up wearing ourselves down and get into a cycle of our brain being erratic and never being able to really calm itself down. So what we just did was activating this vagus nerve. This is something, if you've ever seen an animal get attacked, after they move on from that, they shake it off. They literally shake, and then they feel calm. You may have even seen a dog do that after they got all worked up, and then they shake it off. That's what we can do too, to be able to move that energy into another space where we can calm ourselves. The vagus nerve is responsible for us being able to really, when obstacles come to us, it is the thing that lets us be calm and reminds us to breathe and to move through it. So we're in this time right now where it's easy to almost always be in the fight or flight because there's just so much going on. So I think these expressive meditations allow us to move through that. Our ancestors have been using dancing and shaking since the dawn of man, and that's how they cope with disaster. Along with that, when we dance, when we shake, we're releasing all of our feel-good chemicals: dopamine, oxytocin, serotonin, endorphins. You are literally releasing all of this medicine throughout your body that makes you feel better. And also, when you do it, it activates the center of our brain that does memory, hippocampus. It creates new neurons in there, so we're able to focus better and learn better after we do that. It decreases anxiety and depression. This kind of movement also improves your sleep, and yeah, it helps with bettering your focus. I recommend doing this practice in the morning or any time that you need energy. It's not something that you really want to do before bed if you're intending to sleep when you're heading to bed. If you're trying to jazz up your nightlife, this kind of shaking thing is a great idea. But if you're really wanting to go to bed right after, don't do that shaking exercise. I want to say that self-care and self-healing isn't something you do one time and you're all healed. It would be nice if you could just go to a spa and then you're all healed and you never have to do it again, but that's not how it works. It's a constant practice, and the more we practice it, the more progress we make and are able to come back to that calm space. In these times in particular, we've got to put extra energy into doing self-care. I recommend doing it for about how long we did, so like 7 to 12 minutes of the shaking and the dancing is what will help you. And you can extend it out, but some people, before they go take a test, they'll go lock themselves into the bathroom and shake for 5 minutes, and it helps them a lot. But yeah, we're in this state of time right now where we're in a traumatic experience. Some people might see that as an overdramatic statement, but it is textbook trauma that we are living in right now. lives and livelihoods are being threatened and are lost on a global scale. It's hard to know who to trust or who to turn to, including our own government, including our neighbors. So we're kind of realizing how uncertain our future is. Can't even really, plan for next month because there's just so much uncertainty. And it's important that we can find a place of calm in ourselves and create that personal peace. This quarantine period that we've been going through and starting to ease off of is in order to protect our health, right? Our physical well-being. And we need to acknowledge that our physical well-being is dependent on our mental health. The better we are mentally, the more our bodies can heal. And the more stressed out we are, the more anxious, the more depressed we are, the more our body, it lowers our immune system, and we're more susceptible to disease and sickness. So that's the bigger reason why I wanted to do this subject today, because I really want to make sure that we are doing everything we can to keep our immune systems up and that we're caring for ourselves and each other. Luckily for us, research has shown that our contentment and our calmness in our mind is more dependent on our perspective and what we do rather than external events. So we actually can find a sense of calm despite all the movement and wildness that's outside in our world. And with greater levels of calmness, the more we're able to find joy and more we're able to adapt to the obstacles that come our way. I want to say before I even get going that I am no way advocating for what people determine as a spiritual bypassing, meaning just jumping past all of those emotions that make you feel low and just pretending like they don't exist and just saying, oh no, I feel great. That isn't healthy. Squishing that stuff down makes us more susceptible to disease and makes us more susceptible to blowing up, especially on the people that we love the most, because that's usually who we take it out on and aren't taking it out on ourselves. So I want to say that we should be feeling what we're feeling and that we shouldn't just be ignoring the atrocities that are being committed against us and our brothers and sisters and our planet, but that the best way for us to resolve the conflict, to resolve the issues outside in the external world, is for us to come at it with a clear and calm mind. And I know I've been talking to a lot of people and I know how I have been feeling. So I wanted to just say like what I've been experiencing. Maybe you have too, maybe feeling a little overwhelmed, exhausted. Feel free to put a little thumbs up if you've been feeling any of these things. Tender, confused, insecure, vulnerable, worried, but maybe a little bit grateful too. Scared, resentful, angry, frustrated, depressed, lonely, and torn because of the fact that even though this is all happening, there's also been a little bit of sense of relief that we haven't had to be full on in the rat race and that we've had the opportunity to come back to ourselves and get to know our family a little bit better, and that not everybody has that. So it makes us feel guilty for even feeling those feelings. But feelings make you human. There's nothing shameful about feeling any of them. Emotions are there to motivate us. They are supposed to put us in motion. And we all deserve people in our lives that we can trust and enjoy the company of. I hope that by now everybody has figured out how to practice safe socializing from a distance, but you can still spend time with your loved ones outdoors and see their faces. And I hope that we all have at least one person that we can hug and share air with. We're social creatures, and that is a part of how we can stay calm. These feelings that you're feeling, we need to be able to talk to people about them, trusted people. Maybe that's a therapist, or maybe it's just a good friend, but being able to release those feelings outwardly is really important. And perhaps you don't have somebody to talk to right now, or you need help identifying more what you're feeling. I recommend journaling. Even if you're just writing short little sentences like, I am feeling overwhelmed, I am feeling tender. Doing this, you could draw or paint about it, choosing colors that represent how you're feeling, making, even if they're just basic rudimentary images, that it doesn't matter what it looks like. Singing a song or playing an instrument or dancing to songs that are about how you're feeling. All of this is a way for you to transmute that heavy energy, all of that weight that is you're holding out of your body. And by doing that, you make yourself lighter and feel lighter. It's a real relief to be able to acknowledge what you're feeling. And when they fester in, it makes us more tender and more, either we numb it out and we end up doing things to, you know, drinking or doing different things to try to numb it away or ignore it. But the real goal is to be able to express it in whatever way feels right for you. Maybe you don't have the vocabulary. I know I wasn't able to identify everything I've been feeling until I came across something called nonviolent communication that was designed by Dr. Marshall Rosenberg in the 60s, and it's been used to stop warring countries and fighting in marital issues and gang fights. And it's basically just a practice of expressing how you're feeling and identifying different needs that you have. And they have an inventory of feelings and needs that you could just look up online if you want help identifying the complex things that you are feeling. And one of the things that we can come to that we're feeling is gratitude. And the more that we embrace who and what we're grateful for, writing that down and putting that on your refrigerator, put it in your bathroom, put it on your desk. Remind yourself who and what blesses your life, makes you feel whole and safe and comfortable, and that you have these blessings all around you. It retrains our brain to recognize more of the beautiful things that come in our lives. And so we're kind of identifying our feelings, we've expressed our gratitude, and to give our brains a fighting chance to heal and attain calm states of mind, we have to start at the ground floor, which really means, what are we consuming? I kind of call this my Sesame Street appeal, because this is something that we've been learning since we were little kids, but they really knew what they were talking about. I know when I was younger, I was like, vegetables, but it actually turns out that the more highly nutritious vegetables and fruits and whole grains we eat, the more we send that down to our bellies, where our flora and our gut is located, and 90% of our serotonin is created in our belly. The serotonin is what makes you feel calm and happy. And so if we don't feed it, those little creatures in our bellies well, they end up creating a cycle in our brain that causes more anxiety and more depression. So really taking it to heart that eating very nutritiously and drinking lots of water is essential for us to have a calm state of mind. And kind of tailoring back and backing away from caffeine and other stimulants, whether they're illegal or legal, they still do the same thing, that they cause our bodies to have excess energy and cause us to have more anxious thoughts and scattered thoughts. And then when it's time for bed, our bodies cannot fully relax, especially if you're drinking caffeine in the later afternoon. Your body, even if you do fall asleep, it's not restful. And so then you don't do the healing that you're going to need for your brain and for the rest of your body. The same goes with just backing away from excess processed sugars and starches and packaged food. All of that can jolt you up and then it takes you down. And it's, I'm sure you've seen and experienced sugar crashes, and that happens on small scales all the time and makes it harder for us to be able to deal with the external events that stress us out. And backing away from alcohol. I know a lot of people have very strong bonds with alcohol, and I understand it, and I hold no judgment over it. I think that it makes sense to recognize why you're consuming the alcohol, what's your purpose, how much are you drinking of it, why are you drinking, how often are you drinking. The reason why most people drink is because it puts down your inhibitions, it makes you feel more sociable and calm, and those are great things. I'm not against that at all. But alcohol is a depressant, and so when we drink lots of it, it could actually depress our lungs and our brain and our heart and eventually kill us. But that's not usually what happens. But what does happen is that it can put our inhibitions so low that we end up doing and saying things that we regret later. And the next day, the full-on depressant part comes in, and our brain kind of released all those feel-good chemicals, and all we're left with is like a blah and feeling kind of shame if we did say things. We might not even remember it fully because it affects and depresses the part of our brain, the hippocampus, so we don't even necessarily remember everything we did. And I think that there's a part of alcohol, that relaxing part, that we can kind of hone in. What else can we do that causes that same effect? So there are herbs, that things like lavender, valerian root, chamomile. Hal and I have a nice passion flower and mint tea for breakfast that really helps with that. And cannabis. That is something that has been stigmatized for way too long. It's a beautiful plant that can be abused like everything else, and you really have to figure out what strain works best for you. But THC and CBD have been shown to reduce anxiety and depression and really help with sleep. And sleeping is essential if you're really trying to get a calm peace of mind. Making the effort to have a dark place, turn off the news, don't look at your phone before bed, turn off the electronics, and get into a calm space when you're ready for bed so that you can have a full sleep, stay asleep. There are great yin yoga and yoga nidra are really great ways to help you fall asleep if you're having difficulties with that. And another thing that helps sleep is exercising. And that also helps release everything that we were talking about earlier with those releasing of neurotransmitters like dopamine and oxytocin, serotonin. That can be released in exercise that makes our heart really beat hard. And so deep stretching, because that brings, when you're breathing in deeply, that brings oxygen to all those places. And exercising, like, whether that looks like bike riding or running around or just doing yard stuff, whatever it is, make it so that you're feeling your heart beat. You know, 45 minutes to an hour and a half a day really makes that difference. And turn off the news. You can be informed. I especially recommend something like NPR or PBS NewsHour, something that they're not paid to try to incite fear and hysteria. There's a lot of news channels that really, that's what their goal is and they succeed. But I really recommend staying informed but not constantly having it going, because that is how our brains start to run wild and cannot get calm again. And go outside. Nature is the ultimate healer and grounding force. If you ever start to feel stressed, go outside, take some deep breaths in, feel the fresh air on your skin, go hug a tree, dig your feet into the soil, listen to the birds sing. That is guaranteed to put you in a better space. Even just having houseplants in your house has been shown to lower levels of anxiety and depression. And so we're in this space where we're doing those basic ground floor stuff of eating well, drinking lots of water, going outside, sleeping, exercising. And in the next step of feeling calm and purposeful is setting goals. Set attainable goals for you each day, ones that will benefit your health and well-being, like today I'm gonna drink 8 glasses of water, or I'm gonna go to bed early, something like that, things that you can attain. And also goals where you're trying to meet your basic needs of just like food, water, shelter, whether that looks like I'm gonna go to work today, or I'm going to look for work today, or I'm gonna go to the St. Pete Free Clinic and pick up some food at the pantry. Whatever it is, you are putting energy into caring for yourself, and you are worthy of that. And you feel more calm and relaxed when you know that you are putting that energy into doing that. And also doing something that helps your tribe, your family. Maybe you're just making dinner, or you're cleaning up the house, or you made a nice card for your grandma. Something that is benefiting the whole, and you are know that you are lighting up the space that is around you. And if you have any extra energy left over, make some goals that will benefit your community as a whole. Doing volunteer work, or fighting some social justice issue or planet issue. There are so many things that we can do that, you know, you can make a really big goal, but break it up into tiny chunks so that it's something that you can do each day. So now we're in this space where we're actively putting energy into doing the best that we can. And there are some facts that are still going to have to be accepted to get, and that we just kind of have to surrender to feel calm. And one of the first ones is just surrendering to the fact that life is uncertain. The only thing that we have ever had control over are our conscious thoughts and our actions. And everything else is out of our hands, and we can help steer things in the direction that our heart, that our inner voice, that wisdom that calls us to do, that more courageous voice, not that fearful one, but that one that really believes in you and believes in the wholeness of our world. And remember, what we're going through is temporary. There's going to be a time that we're going to look back with tears and learning and maybe a little laughter of some of the things that happened, but this moment is temporary. And anything that gets us frustrated, the thing that we can always include more into the situation, is patience and compassion. Whenever you're feeling angry at the kids or at things happening in the world, step back, take those slow, deep belly breaths that we were talking about, and think patience, compassion. How can I be more patient? How can I be more compassionate for myself, first and foremost, and for others? Because it's understandable that we're getting, you know, frustrated. So we have to be compassionate with ourselves and patient with ourselves, and then spread it out to others. solutions and opportunities for us to meet our needs are out there, but it requires us to be giving of ourselves generously. Nothing more, nothing less, but giving and also learning to courageously ask for help and receive help from others. I know that there is this imbalance a lot of times. A lot of us who are generous people tend not to be very comfortable receiving. A lot of us who are used to receiving a lot might not have the practice within themselves to give. There's an imbalance either way, and we need it to be even on both sides for us to feel peaceful and calm. We may not always have what we need to thrive, but we always have just enough to survive. Otherwise, we wouldn't be here, right? And when that happens, because that's going to happen to all of us, we're going to transition into some mysterious unknown. And that's okay too. The only thing that we can do is to make this moment count. Do what we can while we're here. Love out loud, be ourselves, be free to be comfortable in our own bodies, and to light up the space that we occupy. Wherever we are, be that beacon of light, and also take in other people who are that light when we need it and we're feeling a little dim. And the best thing that we can do, and really the ultimate thing when we are feeling stressed, is to come back to that slow, deep belly breath. I'm serious when I say to really focus on breathing into that belly. If you've ever seen an infant sleep, you'll know that their bellies rise and fall down. That is the kind of calm, sweet breath that we are trying to attain. That slows our heartbeat down, it slows our mind down. That is all meditation is. People commonly feel very scared when they hear meditation and think it's some unattainable thing that monks up a mountain can do, but oh no, I can't meditate. I hear that all the time. But if you can breathe, you can meditate. It just means being mindful of your body and being connected to yourself. And I want to just talk about, there's practical ways to prove to ourselves that we are not helpless or hopeless, and that is by getting into meditation and making it a regular practice. Maybe setting a schedule for it in the mornings or the evenings that you really set for yourself. And we are going to practice this ourselves. So I would like you, if you can, to go find, I hope you're already in a place that's free of distractions. I'd like you to lie down if you can, or you can be sitting up, but either way, go find a nice place that you can be lying down, just listen to my voice. Hope that you're lying down, your head is down, close your eyes softly, start connecting with your breath. Feel your hand on your belly and on your heart. Take a deep breath in through your nose. Those sweet smelling flowers. And then blow out those dandelions. Keep breathing. Feel yourself slowly calming down, melting into the space. Feel your eyes sinking into the back of your skull. Feel your jaw loosening. Feel free to touch each of the body parts that I'm naming to be able to really stay focused into your body. Any thoughts come in, that's fine. Let them fly in like little birds, but they're not nesting in your mind. They're flying in and flying out. Just come back to your breath, come back to my voice. eyes are sunk into the back of your head, jaw is loose, your tongue is heavy at the bottom of your mouth. Feel the left side of your neck, breathe in, relax. Your left shoulder, relax. Your bicep, breathe in, relax. Your forearm, pointer, your middle finger, your ring, your pinky, all relaxed, limp. Come down to your side body and your chest, relaxed. Rib cage and your hips, let your hips sink and melt into your bed, into the floor, wherever you are. Put your left thigh, your knees, your calf, all relaxed, calm. Your ankles and your feet, feel your big toe relaxed. That next toe in the middle, the ring toe and the baby pinky, all relaxed. Feel yourself sinking free. And onto the right side of our body, your big toe, the next toe, your middle toe, the ring toe, and that little baby pinky toe. Your foot relaxed, your calf relaxed, your right thigh, your hip. Your side body and ribs, relax. Your upper chest and your shoulders, all relaxed. And come in bicep, the forearm, your wrist and hand, all limp. Melted in, sunk in, your thumb, your pointer finger, your middle finger, your ring finger, your pinky, all relaxed. Your neck, your right side, breathe that in. Thoughts are slower, calmer, mind at peace, your heart at peace. And as you breathe in, you're breathing in a lightness, a calmness comes in through your nose, into your lungs, to your heart, into every vibrating cell of your body, filled with a lightness, a love for yourself, a knowingness that you are worth this effort to care and love and breathe calmness in. And let that breath, each breath, that lightness is coming out of your pores. Envision this, this lightness coming around you, coating your body, every organ, every part of you, healed with a loving love of comfort, healing, compassion. And it extends out into your household, coating all of your loved ones. Imagine your loved ones smiling. Smile with them. Imagine your loved ones healthy and happy, coating them with this protective layer of healing light. And let that extend out to your neighbors, to your community. Extending out with each breath into the city, into the state, into the country, all over the world. This light is breaking down all the walls that have kept us from feeling compassion and love for each other. This love and light that is coming through is filling all hearts, making no room for hatred, making there be no more room for fear of one another. Feel this light. Feel this, your heart calm. You can create this anytime. This is your home. This is where you belong. Breathe this in. You can come back anytime. Remember that no one else is going to create this peace for you. You alone create your peace, your contentment. You are your biggest friend and caregiver. And you deserve this. You are worth this effort. You are such a beautiful, love-filled being that deserves to feel calm and secure. From the honey in my heart to the honey in yours, I wish you health, beautiful, vibrant health, peace with yourself, with your loved ones, with the world. I wish you hope. I wish you love for yourself, for each other, for this planet. I wish you clarity, community that you feel safe and loved in and cared for with. I wish you fun and play as much as possible. I wish you the feeling of purposefulness. I wish for you to feel safe, secure. I wish for you to be filled with compassion and to have compassion bestowed onto you. Rest and respect for yourself. Thank you so much. Spending time with me today. If you liked this, I would love to do a session with you. I have my own little practice for children and adults, Eliza Bailstein. Look it up. I'll put a link there. But I so appreciate you coming to spend time with me and to coming to yourself.